Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day to the last syllable of recorded time. And all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way to dusty death. Out, out, brief candle. That's from Shakespeare's Macbeth, Act 5. And if you went back in time and killed your great-great-grandfather, would you cease to exist? If we could travel back in time, could we also travel ahead in time? And if time travel is possible, why haven't we seen evidence of people visiting us from the future? Well, there aren't any scientific answers yet. But until we find them, here is all our yesterdays. Yesterdays was written by a former UCLA librarian named Jean Lisette Ariost. She also penned another Star Trek episode, Is There in Truth No Beauty? It would take a librarian to not only come up with multifaceted scripts whose titles are taken from great works of literature and poetry, but to spin a story around a library and its key personnel as well. Spock and Zarabeth, who's played by Marriott Hartley, are supposed to fall in love until Nimoy pointed out to the producers that as a Vulcan, he doesn't get emotionally involved. But producer Fred Freiberger came up with a clever angle. He figured out that since this story was set in the Ice Age, thousands of years before the Vulcans had evolved to the point where emotion was no longer part of their psyches, it would be plausible that Spock could fall in love with this woman. Everyone bought the idea, and this concept was incorporated into the final script. So what we've just seen is a rare look at the secret emotional life of the Vulcan.